Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RF Design Basics. In this lecture, we are going to study about the lumped equivalent circuit of a transmission line. The key difference between the circuit theory and transmission line theory is its electrical size. In circuit analysis, it is assumed that the physical dimension of a network are much smaller than the electrical wavelength, while transmission lines may be a considerable fraction of a wavelength or many times wavelength in size. Therefore, a transmission line is a distributed parameter network where voltage and currents can vary in magnitude and phase over its length. While ordinary circuit analysis deals with lumped elements where voltage and currents do not vary over the physical dimension of the elements. So a basic transmission line can be shown from this figure, where there will be two elements, two conductors, which is separated by a distance, and in this in between this there will be some dielectric material. So due to the finite conductivity of the conductor, there will be resistance and also inductance, and due to the separation between these conductors, there will be capacitance, and due to the dielectric material loss between the conductor, there will be conductance. So the equivalent of this can be drawn as a series resistance, a series reactance, a parallel capacitor, because the capacitance is between the two conductors, and a conductance, which is due to the dielectric loss in between the material. These elements are per unit length element, and it is denoted by R, L, C and G. Let us consider the length of the line as shown in the figure is delta Z. And the input voltage is VZT, so the output voltage will be, voltage at the other side will be VZ plus delta Z comma T. This delta Z is added due to its length. Similarly, the current which is entering into this resistor is IZT, and the current which is leaving this second port will be IZ plus delta Z comma T, where R is series resistance per unit length. And the unit of R is ohm per meter. L is series inductance per unit length, and it is represented by L, and the SI unit of this is Henry per meter. G is parallel conductance per unit length, and the unit of this is Siemens per meter. C is shunt capacitance per unit length, and the SI unit of this is Faraday per meter. Now let us apply KCL and KVL in this circuit. So by applying KVL, which is Kirchhoff's voltage law, we can write the total voltage in a loop will be equal to zero. So starting from this is VZT minus the total resistance will be R delta Z, L delta Z will be the inductance, C delta Z will be the capacitance, and Z delta Z will be the conductance. So VZT minus resistance R delta Z multiplied by IZT, which is current passing through the resistor. So voltage drop across this resistor is R delta Z IZT minus L delta Z del IZ by del T. So as we know that voltage across inductor will be L di by dt. In this case, the total inductance is L delta Z and current is IZT. So it is del IZT by del T minus, so this complete loop consists of this voltage source as well. So here it will be minus VZ plus delta Z comma T equal to zero. Similarly, we can write KCL at this node where IZT current is incoming and all other currents are outgoing. So incoming current, assuming that incoming current is positive, IZT is incoming, then outgoing currents are Z delta Z, VZ plus delta Z comma T. So Z delta Z is the conductance and VZ plus delta Z comma T is voltage across that conductance minus C delta Z del V Z plus delta Z comma T divided by del T minus the current which is leaving this node is I Z plus delta Z comma T equal to zero. Now using this KVL and KCL equation, these two equation, we are going to derive the Telegrapher's equation. Let us rearrange these equations by taking this and this component in right side and remaining in the left side. So we will have minus R delta Z I Z T minus L delta Z del I Z T upon del T equal to V Z plus delta Z T minus V Z T divided by delta Z on both the side and write the right side into the left side and left side into the right side, we will have V Z plus delta Z comma T minus V Z T by delta Z equal to minus R I Z T minus L del I Z T on delta. Now make this delta Z tends to zero. When we make delta Z tends to zero, the transmission line will have very small sections and this transmission line can be considered as the distributed transmission line, and the property of this transmission line can be considered as small section of the lumped equivalent. So while by taking this limit delta z tends to 0 on both sides, the left side will become, since it is the basic definition of the differentiation, so it will convert to del v z t upon del z, which is equal to minus r I z t minus l del I z t upon del t. Similarly, in KCL equation, we take this component and this component in one side and remaining component in the other side, and dividing by delta z on both sides, we will get del I z t upon del z equal to minus g v z t minus c del v z t upon del t. Let us consider these two equations as equation 3 and equation 4. So if we convert these two equations in frequency domain, how to convert this into frequency domain? Let's say V equal to V naught e to the power j omega t. So dV upon dt equal to j omega V naught e to the power j omega t, which is equal to j omega V. So when it is converted into frequency domain, wherever we have the differentiation with respect to time, we can just multiply by j omega by removing that differentiation. So by rearranging it, we can write the equation 3 and 4 as d vz upon dz equal to minus r plus j omega l iz, and d iz upon dz equal to minus g plus j omega c vz. These are equation 5 and 6, and these equations are known as Telegrapher's equations. Now let us find out the differential equation using these two equations. So by taking the first derivation in equation 5, we will get d2vz by dz square equal to minus r plus j omega l dIz upon dz. And from this equation 6, dIz by dz is minus g plus j omega c vz, which is equal to minus r plus j omega l into minus g plus j omega c vz. Combinedly we can write d2vz upon dz square equal to minus and minus plus, so r plus j omega l into g plus j omega c to vz, which is d2 vz upon dz square minus r plus j omega l g plus j omega c vz equal to 0. Similarly, if we take the equation 6 and take the first derivative and replace dvz by dz with equation 5, we will get d2 iz upon dz square equal to minus plus r plus j omega l g plus j omega c to iz, and this can be also simplified as d2 iz by dz square minus r plus j omega l g plus j omega c iz equal to 0. We can notice that in this equation and this equation, this constant is common, and let us assume that constant as gamma square, where gamma equal to under root r plus j omega l into g plus j omega c. In this expression, gamma is known as propagation constant. And it is given by, gamma is given by alpha plus j beta, where alpha is known as attenuation constant and beta is known as phase constant. So let us write this differential equation and solve the differential equation. So the first differential equation will be d2 vz by dz square minus gamma square vz. Equal to 0. So by solving this, we will get Vz equal to V0 plus e to the power minus gamma z plus V0 minus e to the power plus gamma z. Similarly, by solving the second equation, which is d2 iz upon dz square equal minus gamma square iz equal to 0, we will get iz equal to I naught plus e to the power minus gamma z plus I naught minus e to the power plus gamma z. In this solution, V naught plus is the incident wave on the transmission line, and this negative sign of gamma z shows that the wave is propagating in positive z direction. So negative gamma z shows wave traveling in positive z direction, and plus gamma z shows wave traveling in negative z direction. V naught plus is incident voltage. V naught minus is reflected voltage. I naught plus is incidence current, and I naught minus is reflected current. Now let us take the first solution of voltage, which is Vz equal to V naught plus e to the power minus gamma z plus V naught minus e to the power plus gamma z. We also know that dVz upon dz equal to minus r plus j omega l iz. Let us apply this in this equation. So d by dz of Vz is V naught plus e to the power minus gamma z plus V naught minus e to the power plus gamma z equal to minus r plus j omega l iz. So when we take the first derivative, what we will get? Minus gamma V naught plus e to the power minus gamma z minus V naught minus e to the power plus gamma z, which is equal to minus r plus j omega l iz. So iz equal to here negative cancelled gamma by r plus j omega l into V naught plus e to the power minus gamma z minus V naught minus e to the power plus gamma z. This can be compared with the solution of Iz, which was Iz equal to I naught plus e to the power minus gamma z plus I naught minus e to the power plus gamma z. Let's write this expression here. And compare these two equations. And from the comparison, what we can derive is V naught plus into gamma by R plus j omega L equal to I naught plus. And from the second one, we can write minus V naught minus into gamma by R plus j omega L equal to I naught minus. So from these two, we can write V naught plus by I naught plus equal to gamma by R plus j omega L, which is equal to minus V naught minus by I naught minus. So this is the ratio of incident voltage and incident current, and here it is the ratio of reflected voltage and reflected current and negative sign, which is equal to gamma by R plus j omega L. In place of gamma, we can write R plus j omega L into g plus j omega c square root divided by r plus j omega l. This calculation will give V naught plus by I naught plus equal to minus V naught minus by I naught minus equal to under root r plus j omega l by g plus j omega c. The ratio of voltage and current, whether it is incidence or the reflected, are known as characteristic impedance, and it is represented by Z naught. So the second equation Iz, this equation can be modified in form of voltage by writing Iz equal to in place of I naught plus we can write V naught plus by Z naught. So V naught plus by Z naught e to the power minus gamma Z, and in place of I naught minus we can write minus V naught minus by Z naught. Still we come minus V naught minus by Z naught e to the power plus gamma Z. So let us summarize both the solution here. Vz equal to V naught plus e to the power minus gamma Z plus V naught minus e to the power plus gamma Z. And Iz equal to, in terms of V naught plus and V naught minus, 1 by Z naught V naught plus e to the power minus gamma Z minus V naught minus e to the power plus gamma Z. So there is a difference between these two solution. Here 1 by Z naught is in the multiplication and the positive sign is changed to negative sign. So in next lecture we will take some special case of lossless transmission line, distortionless transmission line and low loss line to understand the various parameters of the transmission line. Thank you.